Very good morning, children. I hope all are fine. How was your holidays? Onam vacation, did you all enjoy? Or you were simply sitting at home? Anyway, it's time for us to go with the first module of this week. And we'll push on to the third lesson of economics, that is money and credit. Alright, as the name itself suggests, no, we are going to see how the money is bringing about an economic development in the country. Credit, I suppose credit everybody knows. The word credit means what? Loan. Now, why do we take credit? Because we have insufficient funds in our hand. So, we go about taking credit or loan from the bank. Okay, we are going to see in detail about all these transactions. How we go to the bank. Why do we apply for a loan, what the bank demands from us, all the details I will tell you in this lesson. Okay, it's a very important lesson because, you know, we all are learning for this purpose also. We are learning to, you know, build capital in our hand so that we bring development in the country. Okay, what all things we are going to see in this lesson is, you can see the slide also, money as a medium of exchange. I'll also tell you about the modern forms of money, what are the various loan activities of the banks, then what are the terms of credit, okay, then formal sector of credit in India, how do we borrow the money, whether we go to formal sources or whether we go to the informal sources of credit, then also you will be, you know, sensitized about self-help groups. The short form of it is SHG, and this SHG is created especially for the poorer section of the society, the vulnerable sections of society. So, you know, about all these points also we will be seeing, right? I hope you are, you know, patient enough to listen to me. Then, okay, first of all, let me tell you about, you know, the barter system. You all know about what is this barter system. In the lower classes also we have studied. No, barter system, it refers to, you know, where a good is exchanged for another good. So you can see the definition that I have given. It refers to the direct exchange of goods and services. And barter system, it refers to the system by which one commodity is exchanged for another without the use of money. You know, now this problem is not at all there, where you have to see that there is double coincidence of wants. Here you're seeing that, you know, we are giving money as a medium of exchange. But in the earlier days, we didn't have money as a medium of exchange. So people used to give a good for the exchange of another good. So it's a very difficult topic also, because, you know, we'll have to find for somebody who is badly in need of your product, and that person should have the product which you require. Okay, so when a person, we say in this manner that when a person desires to sell exactly what he wishes to buy. Okay, so in a barter system where the goods are directly exchanged without the use of money, that is known as what? Double coincidence of wants. So double coincidence of wants is a very essential feature when we are talking about the barter system.